ready to go underground with us tonight. There was a song I was thinking about that part. Welcome to Underground Mode. Your racing career starts here. Take on the toughest drivers on the street and prove you are the ultimate racer. Winners earn cool unlocks and upgrades. Losers go home. Very cool tactics, eh? Yeah, that's how everything should work, right? How's the volume, by the way? Is it too loud? Is it just right? Let me know if you're like, what is he playing and why do I love it or hate it so much? But yeah, Jamanel, hope you're having a solid weekend, and anybody that's just popping in, welcome, welcome, welcome. Oh, we're supposed to be racing right now with this, looks like a Toyota, maybe? Oh, B is still my nitrous. Okay, cool. Well, that escalated quickly. Okay, there's a shortcut somewhere along the lines here. I remember this track. Does anybody else remember this game? Remember this track? I think the game volume for the sounds might be a little loud on the racing sounds and quiet on the music. That's also fine if it doesn't get me DMCA'd or anything. So far I have pretty much all of the original track racing there. Okay, that's kind of a shortcut, but it looks like it's really hard to pull off. Do you not help me hold back nitrous like the other games do? A little frustrated? Oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I'm frustrated sometimes too. Wow, that was a cool way to get stuck sideways. I called off from work tonight. What brings your frustration in? Because I get it. The weekend can be kind of rough. If you also had to like get through something personal or work related stuff can be bugging everyone. I'll definitely show that. It's just a one-shot with the nitrous in this game. I forgot about that. Be, like, conservative about it. Well, Pumpkaboo appears for Pokemon Community Game. Yeah, no, feel free to share if it's worth sharing here. If it's really private or personal and you don't want to share it in here, that is perfectly fine, too. Also got the Discord, which most folks that are regulars over here are fully popped in. Like, okay, a power slide, but, like, have not caught the pump to do. Hopefully you get a catch or a bit of luck with it. Pokedex is yours. I can't remember. Oh, it's just two laps. Okay, perfect. You might actually win this. Race over. Pumpkaboo. That sounds very, like, Halloween themed.
Is that your fantasy?
I had a doctor's appointment Thursday. Oh no! Just recently, Thursday here. It was super high. I'm sorry that has been a concern or, of course, ongoing health issue.
So, which one of these is your car?
I tend to run really low, and if I have any procedures done, they are also, you know, giving me warnings like, you can't do this yet. You need to be in a certain range of other health, so. It might just be my metabolism mixed with the fact that I'm like, I don't want, I have the Stretch Armstrong build. So, yeah, there's going to be everybody along that spectrum, right? Whether you're not ever in normal range, it's high, low, in between, but I hope you can, you know, manage however you need to manage, right? Ultra Mist, dang, that is rough. Yeah, it didn't say that you missed it in time. Usually it'll tell you if it's like, oh, that one has escaped. What game is this? Looks familiar. So it's Need for Speed Underground. It's on the original hardware. I'm switching it up. I haven't played something on the weekend in a minute, so. How are you doing, Sage? Thanks for the like, by the way. I thought that was you. Bam. Appreciate you. We can get the Miata this early? Ooh, that's very tempting. or a Neon, which apparently has worse handling but more top speed. Back in the day, ooh, the Civic. Mmm. Tempting. 10,000. The Miata's only 9,500. Has more handling. Let's go Miata. Let's go Miata. Look, it even has more acceleration when we need it. That's a win-win.
Ouch, that is seriously weak, dude.
Little Miata. It's cute. That was one of the first cars I ever said in a classroom setting that I wanted when I got older. Yeah, you actually have it? So I was going to play the trio of ones I have on GameCube, which I think most people have played on GameCube. Underground 1, 2, and Most Wanted tonight. I dug those out. Friends, if you didn't know, we also have a little giveaway with the new merch in stock. So this is the same as the one behind me, but it's also got this little backwards hat corgi on the back for the logo. The full, like, Slayer Super Show logo part on the front, so. Yeah, I'm doing pretty good. I did take tonight off. I was just congested. I didn't feel like giving any kind of sickness if I was still harboring a cold. I didn't feel like bringing that in to coworkers. So, well, I titled the stream Saturday Night Fever. That's because I was like not feeling it. I don't want to end up with a fever if I was working too hard overnight. So, yeah, there's a sprint, a drift, all about style and finesse. I don't think the Miata. I don't think that's a rear-wheel drive car. Thank you, though. We're going to try it on hard and see what kind of money we can get. That's why I'm playing one of kind of a chill one, kind of one that I have played way back in the day. It's not too, like, much of a simulation game. Like, if I was playing Gran Turismo, I'd probably be frustrated at the edge of my seat. I remember playing a lot of Gran Turismo 1 and 2, though, when I had downtime during, like, vacation and stuff. So what cozy games... We talked last time on, like, genres. What consoles and stuff do you go back to? What games do you guys tend to lean to when you just need something cozy? That was kind of the last question of the day as well. I probably worded it really poorly. So I changed the overlay a little bit. And, I wanted to take the shortcut, and you didn't want to take the shortcut, car. I can tell you didn't want to take it. You have no NOS now. You just have... slow cars. I can also change those EA tracks to different tunes the whole time. I'm gonna have to find all the rock songs right there. These ones are chill, but like, it might be a little bit louder. Some of the songs might be louder than the other ones if they're rock and metal. Most of them I noticed in this one are more like a mix of hip hop than others. Okay, this on hard is actually got some decent racing. Ooh, close-up racing jump cam. I like it a lot. There's the shortcut we want. Ooh, I think I tipped in the wrong way. Reverse pit maneuver or something here. Ah! You lose so much speed in these early races with the cars hitting the walls. But thank you for the well wishes. Yeah, we're doing our best to take it easy. If I take a little bit of time off from something, of course, I gotta go back and expect to still work my normal nights the next weekend, so... all in good, hoping that... that, yeah, we can just have a smooth night. My, oh, you have to follow the road on this one. Some family on my wife's side gets back from an extended time out. Actually out, like, the Philippines. They get back tomorrow. And I wanna spend some time with them. I'm gonna get my kiddo down to, like, a singing... event with her school. So tomorrow's a busy one anyway. Shortcut, style, adding some points. Ooh, we got 625 in the bank. So throwback to whatever this came out in, I think it was like 2002 or so. Need for Speed Underground 1. 2003 Electronic Arts. 2003. Yo, how's it going, Blue? Sky, Blue. Good to see you. How's your weekend, everybody? I've heard there's some ups and downs and all arounds. I myself am not feeling really 100%, but we have the ability to play some classic GameCube games. I'm calling them retro. This is at least 21 years old, so pretty wild to see, right? Want to look cool and go fast? Here you buy upgrades. three performance upgrades already? Oh, I don't think I have any unlocked. Darn. None. Do a trade-in or visual? What is the visual? Accessories are the little extras that help your car stand out from the... Change my muffler tips. So fancy. Oh wow, $500. And it ups our reputation though? Interesting, am I gonna make more money by making my car look cooler? Oh fancy. So they mentioned you were a bit unwell in Discord, hope you feel better soon. Yeah, I appreciate the well wishes. I was just talking to Sage, yeah. I'm still kicking something. It's like a cold that was going around between kiddos bringing stuff home, and since we have like the three busy kiddos, it just happens. I think I like the sniper look, but I might be waiting for later upgrades because I have no money. I want to save that for performance parts. Let's look through the track list, shall we, on this game? Leave Underground mode. We just saved it. Yeah, good to see you again. Yeah, good to see all of you. I hope the weekend fares all right. You know, it's gonna be busy for most, even when it's maybe downtime from work. Fancy. I remember a lot of these songs. If they're too slow, this song. This song is really good. This is when I got introduced to Static X, actually. Some of these I'm gonna make it go on all. The other ones I don't really. Story of the Year, right? Throwback to these 2002, 2003 bands. This is the Cartoon Link wave first because it fits with the game. It really does. It's the GameCube night. That's Dash Gamer too. Dash GMR. I love them. They're good peeps. Haizo, some of the creators as well. They helped out with Juz Cook. They're good peep. Good a mod over there too. Some of these I recognize, and I'm like. Like, this is cool. But yeah, some of them I don't want on, like, when they're just too mellow and too slow. But I like music, right? It's all in-game music, so, I mean, if I can't publish the VOD to YouTube, that's okay. I remember a lot of them. Oh, there you go. I used to have this on all because it comes on the racing, come on the menu. I'm interested to have to reset your speedrun if I'm doing one. Oh, gotcha. That's a pretty good one. Who's who? Funny. So funny. Body rock. Oh, I wasn't a fan of that one, I don't think, when I heard it. T.I. Sorry, you redempt for forced unalive. LOL, yeah. Licensed music will probably get you on YouTube. Yeah, it is a shame. Even if it's... Hear part of it. You can save. It says it's auto-saved on, but we can save it like this. Save the profile. Good old GameCube. Has the variety. EA games always had some interesting tracks. I think my favorite ones were on Underground 2 and Most Wanted. So anyway, let's get through the early races, shall we? But yeah, how are y'all doing overall? It sounds like most folks have been busy. Even if you only get popped by, you know, a moment for a little bit. Thanks for being, around, even for that short bit. If it's late night and you gotta call it soon, totally get that. We're all in different time zones, so definitely take time for you, friends. Like I'm trying to do, stepping off from work even for just a little bit to do this and then crash, really. Probably crash my car once or twice too in this process. Underground racing is a little different than your It's not legal anywhere, but, you know, except for racetracks, is what they tell you at the start of the game, too. I can switch gears, that's right. I can switch into close-range little race mode. I can do first-person race mode. How trippy is that, right? I mean, not bad for the first underground race graphics here. I don't want to get anybody motion sick, though, being on that low-to-the-pavement first-person view. Personally, I like the on the hood on Most Wanted because there's a lot more vehicles, things to dodge, though. Including, like, in Most Wanted, it's daytime hours for all the racing, and you get in trouble with the police, so you gotta dodge police cars and, like, knock things out and avoid spike strips and all kinds of crazy stuff. It's super interesting. My brother, that's probably his favorite underground Need for Speed style game. Cool, we got this track down. We used to get, like, the biggest heavy cars, like Mercedes or something, and try to stay away from the popo until it was, like, GTA level 5, you know, police chases going on. It's pretty wild, because they literally have the copter come out and everything, almost like they got the idea right from GTA. I'm surprised EA didn't actually get in trouble for that. I was like, wait a second, you got a 5-star police system or something. You did the 5-star thing. Car handles really well. I'm not gonna lie, I've seen a Miata or two, and I feel like they were inspired to buy that car because they were like, this is such a fun car to customize in this game. I mean, how many of you have seen, like, a young guy, like, straight out of high school with one of these kind of Miata cars? Just thought, that is the coolest little heavy car. You know they got the idea of playing this, yeah. Play a little bit of Most Wanted on PS3, you wanna say? Nice. Yeah, definitely came out with the PS2 GameCube era. They might have had the adaptation play through the PS3 store when it was still, like, getting updated for graphics. That's about it. Yeah, there was a Need for Speed. I know they started putting them out at the PS3 and PS2 after, like, the track. There's a few ones that sound really similar, too. It's like Need for Speed Carbon. I think Carbon, and then one other one. But yeah, all those later ones that became, like, kind of more centered around the track racing were, I think, adjusted out to even the Xbox original, maybe even Xbox 360 for a company. And then PlayStation side, PS2 and PS3. Yay, we won another race. We're doing all right. We're getting good grades. Time to go race underground, I guess. You're so bright. I gotta wear shades. I don't know. Do you guys like the simplistic overlay for something like this? Just let me know. You know, if it's a love-hate thing. Let me know your feedback on it, fam. Lap knock. I only 3 laps. Perfect shift. Let's try a drag race. These are always fun. Accept message. Name's Derek, but my buds call me Clutch. Call me Clutch. All right, call me Slayer. Alamomola. Get that Great Cherish Ball. I forgot that's even a recognized ball. That sounds really cool. I have not caught this one before. I'm going to try an Ultra Ball. Oh, we got our gold race. Got a good shift. What's Y? Shift up. Okay. Getting some perfect shifts, that's what I need. Let's go. Like Kaizo, timing is everything. One little tap and you change lanes in this one. It's kind of trippy. There's only 4 gears in this? I feel like there's only 4 gears. Oh, snap, I'm gonna be redlining soon. There is. Oh, there's a 5th gear. Okay, perfect. I was like, my old Toyota Corolla had a 4 on the floor. I had an 87 converted with an 89 engine. A Toyota Corolla was my first car. What's cool about it is I put the engine into it. I put the engine into it, and I bought it for $150. Oh, you want another shiny? Yeah, that would have been sweet. Just looking, it's crazy. They have a PS2 game and a PS3 game, both called Most Wanted. Is it Need for Speed? Okay, so you were right, Blue. They did release it on both. In my mind, though, I was like, I don't know. I could see it being an Xbox But I'm surprised it stood as long for the console wars. I'm surprised it stood as long in the library to go all the way up to the PlayStation 3. It's like PlayStation 2 had a gap, but that competed more with the Xbox original Xbox. I think they're different games. Oh, under the same name or something. Just same name. Most Wanted. You know what it is? There's a Need for Speed Hot Pursuit. And I think maybe it was Need for Speed Hot Pursuit. They did a side version. It was like Hot Pursuit Most Wanted or something. Need for Speed 3. For like the PlayStation 1 that they redid. And made it a remastered game. So they could have easily remastered it in a certain way. But yeah, they look different in cover art and stuff. I dig it. We got some money. Got some money and two more races left. Let's figure out how to drift race. Wow, the crowd with speed and drifts. So guys, we're coming up in May soon. I want to tell everybody something exciting. We've got other racing games. Not too many of them. But I got like Test Drive. I think it's Test Drive 6 or something. Oh, this will be interesting. Trying to score. Oh, you got to like literally tap the handbrake. Get the drift going. Okay. We're woof. Wheeling a good one. It's too slow, huh? Well, it's still clocked in. Okay. Wow. Here we go. Running through these tires. Good drip. Great drip. Nice. Alright. Well, they're kicking my butt too, though. Well, we gotta get that multiplier up. Now I see it. This is actually a legitimately hard car to get big drifts in. Like, we're competing with them, but... Oh, we won by like a couple thousand. Woo, that was a tight one. No, we didn't. The Lancer beat it by 200. Ooh. Still unlocked. Terror level 1 vinyl. Sorry, lost this event. You still unlocked something? We'll restart? Okay. I gotta get more speed then. Something. Tokyo Drift Master, right? And like a front wheel drive Mazda. Feels bad, man. Ooh, slow. I feel like I'm going pretty good. You just gotta, like, you gotta drift the entire race, is what it seems like. And there must be, like, special zones that up my score or something. Well, we're getting a little bit faster now. And then just when I think I'm getting a good score, we're, like, tied. You gotta keep it in a low second gear, going about 40 miles an hour, just drifting along the track here. It's tight. People are going crazy with their drifts on hard, too. I don't know if this is the drifting car for me. Just gotta not hit a wall. It's like, oh. I don't know if we did any better. Started a new med today, so hoping it helps. Oh, we just barely snuck it away. I don't think we got any higher score than the time before. We just somehow did better against the computers. Well, yeah, cheers to that, right? Like, definitely to try and find the self-care that works. Everybody's different. We're all built so differently, you know? That's the thing I've learned the most. Yeah. Sending good vibes your way, friends. I mean, I work a lot with residential care, and it boggles my mind. The things, the more you learn about others too, the more you're like, man, I want to learn more about myself, and it's hard taking care of others. So Kai, for those that are busy with their jobs and busy with their life, and if you're taking care of others around your normal sugar blood pressure too, it was 169 to 90. So if you're running high, like, I know there's different folks that'll tell you things that might help too, but yeah, just keep an eye on those levels for sure. If you can, do things for low stress, you know. But whatever will help. You said you have a med for it, but if you feel like you got palpitations or something that's scary, I'm no medical professional. Definitely, you know what I mean? If it's recurring where you think it's a strain on your body for whatever you're dealing with, friends, definitely seek out those that are more educated on that than me. But yes, best of luck. And again, I know it's tough because, like, we're all dealing with stress and different, you know, things, both physically, both mentally. Just got to do what you can. Taking care of you. Because, yeah, there's only one you, right? There's only one body you got to work with. So. I can give advice out. That's about all I can give on the air, you know? We're doing the last hard race here. The pressure's on. Last man standing wins the lap knockout around Olympic Square. Are you appointing with a psychologist too? Because I might be dealing with stress. Oh, I see. So you have stress from some other ongoing thing. I feel it. Well, I hope that things can get better. And like you said, take those steps, whatever can help kind of clear the air for you. Even just the, hey, you made a point of contact. You might have an appointment or not, you know, with. I mean, hopefully those things can help. But again, if it's too personal and you don't want to share, feel free to, you know, pick it and then DM to Discord or otherwise, you know, I don't want anybody to feel like, hey, you maybe shared your vulnerability tonight, and that takes a lot to share, but yeah, I want to make sure everyone knows for your comfortability. Yeah. Well, you can't seem to sleep. You went to bed one night, woke up 2 days later. Oh my goodness, an ICU. That's scary. Yeah, any kind of trips where you have to go that route and you end up in an ICU. It's a care unit site. I'm sorry to hear that. That's super scary. But like I said, yeah. Keep taking care of you, friends. There is, there's definitely some episodes out there that, like, I've gone through, even with, you know, family. Like, we've all gone through, even scary incidents where you're like, wow, I felt like you could have been a way worse situation or something near death. So when I get to stream on the weekends, I'm gonna try to keep it low key, but I know if you all have something that's constantly on your mind, do take care of you, and always feel free to reach out in the mental health tab. Or if you think it's something where it's like, you know, I don't want to share it big widespread on here, because there is certain personal protected info that I would rather you guys know that it is yours to keep, it your personal protection and your right to share. But, you know, Twitch isn't always the safest spot, if anybody can pop into a live chat and use things against you. You don't want to have that happen. So we call it, I think it's HIPAA, right? Whoa, that was a wild hit. We were doing so good. Now we're going to be battling. Like, slowly making it back in the third. I really hope you don't lose. You didn't get knocked out because of that hit. I think we have one shortcut that might save us here. As long as I can take it and not... Ooh, okay. Oh, I think they hit the car too. Hey. Just rob a zombie. Right? Anything you wouldn't share on your own stream, we'll share. Yeah. That's what I want folks to, like, know, of course. This is an open space. It should be a safe space for all. I just want to make sure if it's something vulnerable that, like, might be not only, like, yourself more vulnerable, but triggering to others. I just want you all to just keep taking care. Stay safe where you can, and of course, hopefully things can get better before they get worse, right? Tenable, I mean, anyone that knows how, if he really wants to talk about private stuff, do it in DMs. Yes, exactly. And again, like, I try to monitor if I have one spot that's a place to monitor, I will, like, reach out if it's, yeah. But, like, you're right, there's admins in Discord, and of course, not just that my mods are there to make sure everyone can stay safe, but... Oh, I did it again. Oh, I didn't hit it as hard, but I did it again. I'm trying to go in the middle, because it's, like, the smoother, no traffic route. I guess I can't keep going in the middle. Look at these last lap. I'm kind of tight. But yeah, you know me. This is a pretty chill stream. And I appreciate the words of wisdom, Blue. You are truly a friend that's been around the block as well. Yeah, I think... For the most part, even when I've shared personal stuff, I try not to share, like, a lot of, like, images that could be used against you or, like, private images. Some people will spam stuff in there, and it's like, well, I have to delete that now because it looks bad and it can get your own server in trouble, you know? So you gotta just kind of keep an eye on those things so you don't get your own Discord profile in trouble. But otherwise, like, I try to say, like you said, DMs, whisper... If you're concerned and you're like, oh, maybe I overstepped something, you can reach out and check with the mod or myself, because that's what we're all here for. We have, you know, a main page runner, and then the mods might be quicker if they have a sword and they're out around lurking. You have a question or something, is like, oh. But yeah, you know that. You should all feel welcome here. We are running a tournament next. Rookie tournament. I don't know what that means. Bunch of hockey newbies. Three race series. Wow, we get a lot of dough from this. Do we have any upgrade parts that are like actual? I don't think we get performance upgrades yet, right? No, not yet. Welcome to the. What happens if you change your paint? It doesn't cost any right now? Is that what I'm guessing? Oh, cool. Apply this paint. I'll make it red. I gotta actually buy those things to change the paint. That's great. Vinyls are large stickers you can put on your car. Large stickers. Wait, oh, we did get the tear vinyls. Is that what it was? Oh, that's kind of fancy. It's cute. I feel like I do maybe like a black car with red tear. It'd be kind of fun. I think we're gonna go this way. That's spicy. An octillery appears. I mean, it looks like our car ran over some blood and got it smeared down the side of the car, but at the same time, I'm digging it. Good luck with the auxiliary. Anybody that's still out playing a Pokemon community game, you know, weekend vibes are pretty chill. Hi, Rim, how you doing? Hey, ya. Good luck with the catches, both of you. We're playing a little bit of this, playing a little bit of that. I'm going to mess around on Underground 2 after this, see how it compares graphically. This was the first Need for Speed Underground on GameCube, rendered, of course, in more of like a 720 upscale. I've updated the frame a little bit, so it should fit on my current... I like the song. So it should fit in my, you know, in 80s. How's the weekend treating you, though, Iron? This is the first Static X song I think I ever heard, and it was literally thanks to the EA tracks. This is back when they actually did put some pretty good music in games. I mean, they had Avenged Sevenfold and a bunch of different titles on... I think they may even had System of a Down on Underground 2, but probably more Most Wanted. That one got a rated T, whereas these first games for Need for Speed got actually rated E. Everyone. I actually remember them. Yeah, Wayne Static actually passed away young. He was a busy dude, but I think he hit too much hard substances in his life. I want to say he passed away before he was even maybe 50. Unfortunate. So gotta take care of that body still, right? Sorry that anybody's going through our personal battles. There's a lot of different struggles out there. I feel like 80% of everything might be mental, so, you know, check in with those that can help release your mental stress, your mental strain. Even if you're just here and it's relaxing to you, I hope you enjoy your time in the stream. Quiet was supposed to help family stuff, but wound up being just a couple tires is what you helped them out with. Okay. I read tires and I was like, oh, you're tired. I got tired from helping things around the weekend, but we did a couple parks, went out with the kiddos, a few parks with the nicer weather we had today. And then I found out I was kind of harboring a little bit of a cold and congestion, and maybe we did overdo it. My youngest is still only 3.5 months, but the middle boyo, he's been kind of taking a cold. I think I finally picked up some of that. Yeah, Wayne Static had a really unique style. I gotta say, I appreciated their music for the time, what they put into it. It got kind of repetitive, the styling of it. Oh, there's some dude picking up. Jeez. Racing up here, isn't he? I don't know what you're racing in, but it feels like it's faster than mine. Try not to get too nervous. Don't pass me here. Just drive sane. Cool. Let's go visit friends tomorrow, hopefully. Sounds like corn if you squint. Yeah. They need more of that heavier bass, that low range, right? But I appreciate some of that earlier grunge kind of metal. Their stuff had a very unique sound. The singer, he always kind of had that same, I'm dying to death, man. You know, it was like not quite screamo, but kind of a harder, like a harsher sound. I had one called Cannibal. It was the hit song of the newer album before he actually stopped, you know, making music and passed away. Wayne Static did. They got a replacement singer, but they were definitely out of the loop and not going to be able to produce music for, I want to say, like at least 4 or 5 years when I heard that news hit. Pretty big news for them. Because Static X had music all over, and then they were making albums pretty regularly a year, but. Yep. I hope things go well for visiting friends if it works out there, Iron. And, you know, thanks to anybody for stopping tonight. It's not my normal, you know, evening stream, but I think tomorrow's going to be a rest day. We have some family coming into town, so we are also doing the family things. Family is actually getting back into the swing of things for my wife's side. So we're going to host a little barbecue. And I can't not drive straight. This road is too bumpy. Who made this road? I'm jumping my car. There's the shortcut. I always miss that. I'm not looking at the barrier. Good music for the tournament here. They're racing music here. There's a few groups that it's just always fun to hear their tracks in the old school. A little bit of like the punk rock, kind of the alternate rock, indie, metal, from back in the early 2000s. You know? It hit a little different. It wasn't maybe as hardcore as everything is dominating itself into its own genre. It has to fight really hard. These ones were almost like they were not trying super hard in one genre, but feeling like it was crossing the different themes. Fun fact that you learned today, Uranus apparently has a day-night cycle. It's a long night. It's a long night for Uranus. 42 years for each side. Wow. That is a bit long. Dude just tried to pit maneuver me. Not gonna lie, that was rude. You guys are trying hard in this tournament, aren't you? He's gonna pass me still? So close. Oh, snap. That was a close race. Not gonna lie, that was a really close race. It's far out there. Yeah, yeah, Uranus is hanging out there. It's a little dark spot in the corner of the world. Corner of the universe. Is my juvenile humor hitting yet? I want to say I've heard these kind of quality jokes in, like, Austin Powers style movies. I don't know why. It just hit me. Not why. Okay. I'm just gonna say go, and I'm gonna put the pedal down. Why does your car look so much more gangster than mine? You got way cooler vinyl and, like, a spoiler. I'm just black with a little red tear on the side. Whoa. Oh, jeez. You can go right through the barrier. I forgot about that. Oh, we got some time to make up now. I was like, is this the road? And then I saw the arrow too late. Or if you look closely on a clear night, you can see. They gotta go around the truck. This is a good thing. He got slowed way up by that truck. Holy snap, I might have just bought myself enough time for first. Oh baby! Race is over! Ah! We won the tournament, I think, right? They were all Miatas? This is the only thing that compete with me, obviously. As a Miata. We had a nice lead though. Thanks for the GGs. Perfect hard tournament. 6250 in the bank and unlock the following performance upgrade. Level 1 engine exhaust, level 1 drivetrain, level 1 tire packages. Nice. No nitrous yet, but we'll go with it. Why do they want me to restart? Why is the first options? Just think about it. You're playing a game for the first time. You're like, yes, I won. You're smashing the A button. And it's like, oh, what did I just hit A to? Oh, no. And you restart the race that just won you the tournament. Like, come on, EA. What are you trying to do? Make the game way longer? Way longer for me? You should troll me. Yes, exactly. You're over here celebrating, and you're like, wait a sec. They play Crew some. Oh, nice. The Crew. Did you hear about the game getting delisted recently? When you say delisted, something went off, right? Was it because of the devs? They, like, screwed something up? This is why companies keep swapping their GUIs every game. Oh, my goodness, right? The interface stuff? Just to play with you? It is just to troll you. You're right, though. Completely right. This is four random name brands because they needed to drop those name brands in the game. I mean, obviously, I'm a big Venom and Apex Racing fan here. But they start getting less brands. We'll just go with this. Ubisoft literally went in on Steam and took out of customers' libraries. Right, just taking content out of others because they're like, I don't know, these work for their games, right? Ubi just decided we can't have the game anymore, actually. Took it out of my library and shut down the servers. Oh my goodness, it was an online-only game and you paid for it, though. Wouldn't that just make everyone pissed? Like, well, if you're gonna do that, and straight up delist it by, like... Was it Ubisoft that made the crew? The crew, was it made by Ubisoft? Because, like, those kind of games, they still let you have access to it if you paid money. I remember reading about that, I guess. Straight up removed, yeah. They're dead to you, yeah. Okay, so maybe you don't want me to play Far Cry on stream. I feel like that's the only saving title that I actually enjoyed, though, on Xbox 360 on up. You know the guy who makes Freeman's Mind, Ross Scott? He's literally going on a warpath about it. Has a website to contact officials about it. Well, that's good. Because honestly, these companies shouldn't be throwing their power around like that. Like, if you pay good money for a content, at least let them play the game until... Like, okay, say you shut the servers down, that's fine. But let them play the game and show that it was existing in your library. So you can be like, look, I had the nostalgia that I still owned it back in the day when it was live. That's crazy. I'm a big Yokohama. Yeah, let's do Yokohama things. Why not? It doesn't matter. They're all the same exact. What you get out of it. Everything else is an illusion, right? Yeah, I don't think so. You saw Cult of Mush on YouTube mention it and checked your library. Yep, it was gone. Wow. That is something. I don't know what to tell you on those things, you know? It's like... They want to take away more than they give, I guess. A million better ways to handle it than how Ubisoft did it. They just refused to. Yeah, if you're going to sweep something under a rug, it's definitely not the way. It's definitely a way to turn your people against you, I would say. For sure. Luckily, I'm just playing the other alternately... bad developers before they were bad with microtransactions. I'm playing an EA game, so I can't really speak too much on it. We'll put some new speed, we'll put some Kenwood amps in this bad boy. We're stealing, rocking the street glow. Here we got Venom. Venom's actually a cool movie. I put Venom on the back. What else do we have? Something we could put on the hood? Oh, no, we don't have any hood stuff. We're not part of that hood gang yet. Well, that's kind of boring. Stick with what we got. You gotta remind me to hydrate, though, friends. Snom appears. You think that's the Venom logo for the energy drink brand? It probably is. It's not even a legit... Well, this might have been before the Venom energy drinks came out, though, to be honest. This was like 2002, 2003 development done. I don't think Venom stuff was out until I was in college, which was like 2008, 2009. I want to say... But they probably did auto parts, like performance-enhancing auto parts. And then maybe they didn't do auto parts after a while. This game came out, they decided, oh, our logo's cool, let's put it on energy drinks. I don't know. Just a thought, I'm one to talk, I'm drinking a Smash Vodka Soda for the reason that it calms my throat and is gonna take the edge off for a minute. Time trial. PJ's time trial, no less. Well, if we got enough money, maybe we can win this. Venom, the actual, the company that created the energy drinks, too? 2002. Okay, well, they've been out a while, then. I don't think... The guys. Graphics.
You think you're better?
Think you're better.
And maybe I'll help you out.
Yeah, what I think is really funny is after, Underground 2, they stopped doing this style of them, and they started doing, like, cut-out cinematic scenes. They were acting. The people were full-on acting, not doing CGI and voiceovers. Get from the airport to the downtown core in 1 minute 35 and see what TJ has in store for you. All right, TJ the ripped my sleeves off mechanic guy. That's how you know he's really tough. Yeah, and Burnout was your favorite racing series? I appreciated Burnout 3 Takedown more than any racing game. Because that game, I wanted to play all of it. I wanted to play every destructive scene on it. I wanted to definitely enjoy that game. And you said the Monster thing. Let me read the Monster thing for just a second. Did we win? We had like 0.3 seconds on the clock. Oh, we had 1:35 to do it. And we did it. I was just chatting the whole time, and we managed to do it. What a clutch little race. I just saw that timer was down less than a second, and then I'm like, oh, the finish line's right there. That was a tough race, and I had all the upgrades on. Wow. Lemonade and tea, they had a monster drink that was like, oh, I remember that. Like an Arnold Palmer, but a monster drink of it. Didn't have that much caffeine anymore. Yeah, I try to stay away from it as much as I need it sometimes at the end of, like, a night shift. Just to, like, drive home and be alert enough to, say hi to the kids, have some breakfast, some brunch, and then crash. Oh yeah, I didn't stream fast today, but your friends and I were, you were playing it a little bit. You're playing it off, that's fair. Off stream is a good time to just connect with friends though and have a chill time. I'm glad to hear that, Shaman and friends. If you got to play some Asmo, Lethal Company, I noticed was playing, getting played a lot by some of my mod friends yesterday. That's fun to watch, to be honest. TJ agreed to modify a car with a unique performance upgrade. Oh, if we didn't beat the time, he wouldn't have given us the upgrade. That is wild. It's a tight timeline, wow, too. Select the unique performance upgrade, part. Just like that. So take one. Can't even read it. We have three options. Ooh, engine exhaust for sure. Drivetrain somehow is improving handling. Drivetrain is your... is your transmission. You'd think tires would have more of an improvement on handling, but drivetrain is doing my handling. It must be a really lightweight transmission part. Ginseng has mostly replaced caffeine for you. That's good. That's a definitely more natural herb one, right? Ginseng. I'm trying to think. Is that a root from, like, ginger? Ginseng? It sounds so familiar to what's, like, ginger. I don't even know if that's true. Blue, but yeah. We just have one Atlantica challenge. Oh, it's a new map. Looks like this has a roundabout in it. Yeah, pay attention to these. There's 111 races in this. That's wild. Throw your stuff against three hot hatchbacks and a three-lap race through Atlantic. All right, this that's unrelated plants. Okay, completely unrelated. Ginseng is its own herbal supplement. Got it. Oh, I appreciate the feedback. I'm going to try, like I said, after this race, I think we'll be 9 races in. We'll try Underground 2. And then we'll switch it up with a little pole. I like our little Venom Miata. Say it was once a good sports energy drink, too. There's different kinds, of course. It's an energy booster. Works all right. That's good. I've seen it brought up. Like you said, it's probably a lot more correct than the additives put into like energy drinks where it's all just caffeine and like really fake stuff that has a blast ton of B vitamins and acts like it's good for you, but it's really not. I mean, hell, if you just have too much vitamin D, you're just gonna piss out all the extra, right? I don't think the guy wanted to go up here, but I kind of made him go up here and then get stuck. Oh, poor yellow car. You were going to be my best opponent yet, and yet I kind of hit maneuver you back there. That was a mean move, wasn't it? In other news, unrelated pants. I read that wrong. I forgot you can actually interact with these cars and knock them around. In most other Need for Speed games, the enemy cars are very hard to manipulate. They're, in fact, like, the boss cars and stuff, you can never knock off the track. They are, like, glued to their surface, and you bounce off them like a pinball. Just so y'all know, it's a different thing. Wow, those guys disappeared back there. Ever play Split Second? It's been a minute. Yeah, I think I have. Fun racing game, you remember, as well. There's one called Blur. It was my favorite game because it combined almost a Mario Kart style aggressive tactics where you could shoot things at the enemy cars, but it had all realistic kind of cars to unlock, even like a Ford F-150 and like all these custom old school ones. Blur was similar to that, yeah, came around the same time. I really liked Blur, and some people didn't, but the online stuff was competitive. I think it brought a lot of life to the series. I don't know if I can take a ton more of this music. It's very repetitive, right? The racing music they put in these games. I'll probably be switching gears to Underground 2, see what that feels like. I'll just let the tracks play for what it is. Yeah, one more lap of this, yeah. Dragula vibe, right? This just in, Slayer slays enemy cars. Film at 11. Yeah, Shaman, thank you. The weekend update here. Tries to slay them all. Catching Pokemon after who knows when. Now, honestly, it could be, like I said, if y'all don't want to see Most Wanted, which is the daylight version of this, with the cop cars intertwined, a little more corny, especially the cutscene, a lot more corny. You gotta hit that jump straight as ever, or that happens, and then you really wish you didn't do it. That might be a downfall here. Went wide, and he's got more speed than me. I want to say I'm going to get past here. I'm going to try to scare him back away so I can take a better line. Wow, neck and neck. And they're taking my route here. Yeah, I could not make a false move at all in that last lap, but we won. Let's go. That's the hell weekend update, right? Ooh, those weekend vibes. There you go, little John and the East Side Boys, man. Good way to wrap it up here. From the window, we unlocked the 2003 Ford Focus ZX3. Wait, like, ours to keep? I'll take it. Cool. There we go. This one's there. You've done this before, haven't you? I've always enjoyed racing games. Most Wanted was always my favorite out of Need for Speed, yes. But again, it's been ages. I haven't played this title in probably about 5 or 6 years. But yeah, I've beaten this series. I've definitely beaten this whole series. And I would say, like, my confidence with driving has always been decent, so yeah. You've heard this song way too much. Yeah, already. Just in this little bit that it was on for, you probably heard it too much. Alright, what does it say if we want to... This is like the jam for y'all. But I'm gonna have a quick poll. What game we doing after this? Like what we see. And we got Need for Speed. And I ain't taking no for an answer. Most Wanted as an option. What's it gonna be? We got Pokemon XD. Gale of D. These nuts. Or we got Paper Mario. It continued, of course. Paper Mario TTYD. I think it's like part, I want to say 7 is where we're at. So yeah, I got 10 minutes. We might as well start a poll. You guys have a lot of chatters in here, you know? You feel better sometime this week? Just get some Borderlands in. Are you guys playing Borderlands 2 or 3? I forget. I'm trying to get back into 3 myself. I never finished that one. I got like a couple chapters in and I just kind of threw my shoulders up. Oh, that's right. Not even those two. It was in between. Borderlands 2. After that, they made the pre-sequel, which was supposed to be before the sequel. It was before you met Mr. What's-His-Face, right? And you go off to like the moon. That's a pretty cool game. Different, but it's cool. When you get to Bayview, my gal Rachel will hook you up. She's loaned you her ride. It's at the airport waiting. Well, change things up. Help clear your head. So be gentle. Yo, okay. Good luck, bro. Be seeing ya. Good luck. We're taking a flight into Bayview, and it just is one of them cliche little underground nightlife cities that's supposed to be like a mix between L.A. and some little... I don't know, this is probably supposed to be some Bay City like San Francisco and LA combined. think that's what they're going for. But yeah, I hope the pre-sequel is a pretty cool jam. I never really completed that one. I completed 1 and 2. Borderlands 1 and 2 were my jam. You're playing through Borderlands 3 with someone? Kind of fell off it, though. Yeah. I want to pick it back up. I was telling people, even my mods, like, hey, if we get the chance, Sinwolf wanted to try Borderlands 3. And he said it's, I think, cross-play between all the consoles. I don't think you and Irem will do 3, but I did promise to play it with Midnight Bell. Oh, cool.
So we're jumping in a Nissan, what is it, the 350Z? Back when the 350Z dropped, it was pretty cool looking.
Still, I mean, it's an interesting little, like, peppy tuner car. I will return to gameplay. This is a long message. I don't know if you can even, like, read, like, the graphics of this. Can you read the license plate that you can choose? Oh, yeah, this is, wow. This car is actually peppy from the start. That's kind of cool. Am I supposed to collect those little info things? I think I am. Status, career, stats, and progression. I see another one over here. Wow, okay, the graph. Not the graphics, but the actual handling of this is pretty whippy. Oh, it is crossplay, though? Yes, perfect. One of the three happens to be crossplay, so I could play on Steam Deck while they played on PlayStation. Oh, okay, truly crossplay. The different options like that. That's cool. Ooh, that's a cool effect on the B. I forgot they added a little bit of that streamline. Learn about drag racing exactly and drafting. Wait, can you race people like just like this? We just got to town and we can race them? Oh no, that's cool. I have the lead. I should probably keep the lead. I'm pretty sure I just smashed him into the wall. Oh, I won $100. I feel so sorry for that soul. I just totally ruined their race day. That was a victory outrun introduction. He hit the D-pad to use their little... What is that logo? It was like sponsored by some kind of... Singular Wireless sponsored this. You're the reason I have that DLC. I bounced super hard off of number 3, yeah. Legitimately, the only portions of it you liked were the casino DLC, love gun and love guns and tentacles. I almost read that as testicles, I'm not gonna lie. That is interesting. It happens to be crossplay. That's cool on LabBlue. I'm glad that it is more crossplay for me to be able to also play with so Sinwolf wanted to maybe down the road. We'll see what games line up though. This guy's kind of flying, not gonna lie. I might lose to them. Except for when they do that. Wait, what? Are they trying to turn around? Oh, they were trying to turn around. How did they get the lead? They did not have the lead on that. They tried to turn around at the start of the race and it let them. Oops. Cinematic fault. I'm gonna lose this race, aren't I? Alright, well now I'm getting distracted at the start of the game. Why do they do that to me? Awful, awful game. I see they take the little only exit you can do over here. All right, look, we can race. Let's do this. I want to win. They seem to have a little bit more competitive edge. I was going to see if they could try to go straight. Yeah, to be honest, I wasn't having much fun with it. Wanted to finish it eventually, though. Yeah, I understand that. For sure I was aiming for Zane clones and shield, but... Oh, wow, broke that taxi. Kind of feel bad. I wonder how soon it'll be before I can actually break away and win this one. I think it'll be pretty quick. Closing in on... There we go. Like a minute and a half. For sure, Ember's Anglone is a shield build for one of your play with Bell. Gotcha. Zane, is that a, that's a character that crosses over to 3, but it sounds like a very similar character to pre-sequel. There's a specific build you do in the casino DLC. Oh, cool. So that's the DLC you're talking, that is through Borderlands 3. Yeah, I didn't really tinker with it much. Changing steering controls. Huh? Various settings. Up to engage your circuit. Thought getting in a mech was cool, so was that one. And be, oh yeah, oh, they have a full mech suit style for Borderlands 3. I forgot about that, yeah. Let you activate all of his kill skills at once. That's a cool build. I do appreciate it.
I did work the last night, friends, so again, I'll try not to make this a late stream. I'm just gonna offer that other third game for the variety of GameCube games we're playing tonight. And then we'll probably only be on for another hour, I want to say, which is before midnight my time. I want to wrap it up.
Crap, I almost forgot to, like, hit the gas. Okay, right trigger, let's do this. I'm drafting. Oh, I forget, you get more boost in this one just from actually racing against them. Sweet. See, in this one, they don't budge like the other one. They push back harder. Avoided accident. I like doing that. Oops.
Oh no, we hit the middle pylons.
Luke. This is another band that I think has multiple titles for their songs. Like across all the different Underground series. Ow! I hit back into them and it broke me something fierce, but not them. Okay, gotta remember not to follow their butts closely. Also got the Iridium trees now. Oh, nice! I remember the Iridium little crystals from Borderlands 2. Nice, they must use that as ongoing currency through all the titles. That's later in the game then, for or is that through Borderlands pre-sequel, I'm thinking. Pretty epic. Amos is insane, I destroyed everything in 3 with her and have infinite ammo. Dang. Those are some cool sounding builds. Okay, we're in second. And we have one more lap after this. Oh, this is a long race. They don't mess around on this one. They have like a freeway race that goes all around the outskirts of the track. Yeah, but what are we doing? What are we doing? What game are we doing after this? Let me know, friends. There's just like another 30 seconds left on the pole. I want to say I don't know what the reveal will be until 30 seconds is up. Ooh, look at that. Rain is now here. I wonder if that actually does feel more slick. Swallow escape. Dang, let's hear and escape it. But yeah, if you guys are tired of any speed games. Pokemon got 5 votes. Alright, so looks like we're playing some Pokemons. Holy crap, that poor van. My brother and I used to line up a bunch of crazy cars and try to run through them. I don't know, we were destructive. My little brother was like 4 years younger than me. But when this came out, we would have fun lining up cars and trying to jump them on like a certain part of the track where you could get a bunch of air. And then we would try to do like those kind of maneuvers. We're going full speed and seeing how far they fly. We just pretended they were all test dummy cars. They were there for the... Oh no! Keep hitting everything, man. This game does not want me to finish this race. Keep it in mind, I honestly don't know when schedules will align. Alright, we'll play next. Hey, no worries. If you're up for recommendations, you're just throwing away all HP you can. Ever played Twisted Metal? Seeing the car destruction reminded you of it? Right? I liked a couple games early on the N64, like Destruction Derby. The N64 version of that, Destruction Derby 64, was amazing. But also, it didn't have the guns and the wild stuff. It was just kind of it hit different in a good way. Wow. 3.5 minute race. That's still pretty good.
Specifically, the DLC drops the Seeing Dead class mod for Zane. Whenever you damage an enemy, there's a 10% chance of activating. Oh, kill skill is a 10%. That's pretty good.
Well, we're racing into an RX-8,
and they were still like 30 seconds behind. Those are pretty good cars for their day. They're a high compression, though, for like, yeah.
Oh, this one at least has continuous, the first option. One of Zane's kill skills increases the duration of his active action skills at full steam. You can keep all your kill skills going perpetually.
Ah,
that is wild. One of Zane's skills only makes it so when your ability... When using an ability, it counts as a kill, so if you have the Iridium tree, you have 3 free kills. Oh, wow. I don't know with the Iridium tree stuff, but it actually sounds pretty dope.
Hey, dude, what's the holdup? You lost or something?
Oh, that's right. So we have these races. We can go, potentially we can, left on the D-pad, oh, we can look for the other sprint race and do it to get some more money before we actually get our first car that's supposed to be the stock car in this game. This is the loaner car. The nice 350Z is like the loaner car. I don't know if I want to race another shenanigan race for a pretty cool paint job. Looking for... Wait a second, is this a secret? This is a secret race. Huh. It's a small little race, but it's cool. Don't matter to me, though. If you want to race with us? Oh, this isn't actually Rachel. Yo, dog, you ain't Rachel. Pretty much Zane just becomes absolutely busted by juggling his kill skills over and over. That's cool. Yeah, you guys know a lot about the future Borderlands titles, the newer ones like pre-sequel and Borderlands 3. Where I haven't really finished those, but I do want to get back into trying more. Like Borderlands. Number 3 would be pretty fun to play. Oh, this is a tiny track. I like that. Got 2 laps on, that's it. Like we're down in like Vegas or something. I can't remember if this one's the one introduced. You can do like a slow-mo turn. Being up on the C-stick. I think it was the next one. Oh, you feel the need. The need for speed. Hey, appreciate you, Jeff. How are you doing tonight? Oh, snap. Did you copy your sound alert source, Nerdy? I feel like that was an accident. Nerdy fam. Thanks for joining us. It says alert, alert. Hold on, should I click that? I feel like it's a source for an alert that you want to play. Oops, that was supposed to be my raid message. I'm straight up clicking it. You're my mod. I don't think it's gonna hurt me. Oh, it is your source. It doesn't have anything for me. You're my mod. You're good. You're good. Well, welcome in, Raiders. Thank you, Nerdy fam. How was the Ocarina of Times? How was the Ocarina of Times stream? Should I time you out for a second? Sub raid. Thank you. Yay. Nightbot has a message for us. Thank you for the raid message. I'm going to time it out for a second so that I can untime you out. How does it work? Untimeout. There it goes. I don't want that to be out there if it's your own personal source one, but... much love to you, Nerdy. I appreciate that. Make sure you're modded in here still. There you go. You're still modded in here. If you time them out, I forget, you actually lose the privileges there. If you time them out, it's like, oop. Oh lordy, I had to do a 360 turnaround and still somehow we're battling for second and first. Yeah, we're playing some Need for Speed, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. Well, we didn't lose because we were just barely behind up for the first lap. You quit, brain is broken. Oh yeah, it was a busy night. You had a co-op, randomizer, right? You're playing with three other folks on Ocarina of Time. If you guys enjoy that randomizer fun, the shenanigans of, I want to say, Ocarina of Time, they've been playing some Minecraft, they are good peeps. Definitely go check out Nerdy. It is late. I was going to say, I took some time off of work literally so I can just chill and relax and play some games. So here we are. We're going to be playing a little bit of Pokemon XD, maybe for like a good hour until it's late, late night. It's that nerd. Heyo, Jeffy. Thank you so much for the resub, friend. I owe you. Would you like the spicy chip? Would you like some habanero barbecue almonds? Not officially sponsored, but also brought in by Blue Diamond. I would totally take your sponsor. Let me eat your nuts. Or would you like to put a recommendation for more time in a game, a retro game of your choice? Well, we have the SNES list going. We also have pretty much any NES, SNES game we could add in for 15 minutes of time. You surprised? You recognize that as Aphelion Emo. Oh, yeah, let's go. Plasma's in there, too. Is that My Name is Jeff with a flying hot dog? I love that. That is beautiful emo. Flying with like a little rainbow. I forget that there's a game that has that cute little rainbow trail behind it. It's like Bit Trip Runner or something like that. I didn't know you could have a hot dog character. You know? Talking about the Zane character from what? Borderlands 3 still, right? We got some mods, activate mini crits, eraser, which is... It sounds like a really wildly... boosted character. You guys can get all these cool crits and stuff set up. Well, I need to have this on autosave, it seems. Or I can just choose not to save it for later. It's obvious autosave is not functioning on this original Need for Speed Underground 2 game. Alright. For the spicy chip. I got some, we're back down the list. We're on red pepper. Give a couple Tacolitos in the red pepper. A little Morty! Good eye, yeah, it's filling in some of my favorite emotes, to be honest. We found some secret races, and she's mad at us for, I'm putting the word out on you, and that means no more racing till I say so. Get over here, now! Wait. She said no more racing. But there's another race we can go use. Should we make? Woo! That's pretty good. The red pepper's kind of like a Tabasco, but not as hot. Did we make her more upset at us by racing one more race before we actually return the car? Get to the car lot now. Hey, I want my car back. You better haul over there ASAP or I'm putting the word out on you. That means no more racing until I say so. But that was a secret race, right? Go flex on it. An inside joke with a hot dog and your JPEG alert, so I have the flying hot dog now. I love it. Where's the car at the race? I want to race this car. Well, they're actually pretty fast.
Oh no! I chose a race with the wrong guy.
Oh man, I think they were make that turn. Lost the lead. Have the lead. Oh good, I have the lead and they made a turn. Oh snap, they got out of that real fast though. Oh no, I think they got stuck again. Yay, I win the outrun. 38 seconds later. Also, that was a good trial run to know what to do to set up the one we plan to do eventually. Yes, that's what I was going to segue into was, you know what? She said get to the car a lot now. I don't want to piss her off too long. Let's just do one donut and make our way over there. This is a cute fountain. I didn't know you could go through the middle of this. The blue thing's the car a lot. Since I have Pokemon XD next on the burner, friends, I'm going to have to look at that build. Yes. That's an holy. Those emotes are pretty interestingly unholy there. Blue. I gotta say. Philly. The Philly flex, huh? Okay, up on the D-pad on the future one, or the C-stick here. Up on the C-stick actually changes Oh, there's some cash up here. Let's go. Free cash! 50 bucks, just like that. Well, something's jamming on my radar here. Something was jamming. Enter the shop. All right. Go talk to the angry lady who said I can't race her car anymore. You can make it even worse. Add in its complex root skill and it'll increase the splash radius to ridiculous sizes, making each one hit everybody in an arena. Dang, sounds like a time. Y'all are working with some magic with the builds. She's like, you didn't do some illegal racing on the way here, did you? I don't know if I trust you with my cars anymore. I'm only gonna give you a Honda Civic now. I like how this is all like cinematic and he's just like a comic, but then she's just like, extreme close-up. They paid me to be in this game. I love finding busted game builds. Yeah, Rainbow, I can attest. Get that. Don't you do that again, mister, or I'm gonna be mad. And then you go and race your car like three more races and they're like, get you the car alive! No more funny business! Ooh, Nissan 240SX, probably the most baller car in this entire game. And it's rear-wheel drive. So you can actually use it for the drift races. Handling, not great, but it's acceleration and it has more top speed than most of the other cars. What do you guys think? Should we go with the 240? Nissan 240SX is actually here pretty primo, like actual drift and like road rally kind of car. Depends on, I guess, how you build it. We already got over $1,000 just from doing the early races. Gosh, I remember thinking the graphics on this game was top tier, and I mean for the time it was great. This is a big step up from Need for Speed Underground. We were playing the first Underground, and it was like, oh cool, you can put vinyls on your car, and then we just shifted gears. This is the early, obviously, parts to Underground 2. And the day was 420, and you didn't blaze it. Blue! Is there still time? Unless you're like, oh no, you were further eastern, right? You're like central time? I mean, you can still. Mine is like, we had another hour left on the clock here. Oh, now we got the slowest little car to go out here. We got an arrow to tell us where to go. See you at the garage. Now you got a set of wheels. Head over to my garage. Don't look for races, because he doesn't want you to have any. 20 is a birthday for your family. Oh, nice. There you go. You get an extra reason to celebrate. Wild Mantine appears as well. You know, blazed it. There you go. Nerdy fam in the house. Hey, thank you so much again for the raid. I appreciate you, fam. You are extended fam here. I hope you always feel welcome back. I am Slayer. We play a lot of different variety, including this, which is technically blown up in a different format. My OBS, I've just kind of... I'm choosing to, on certain games, play them a little more full screen with a little less clutter. The alerts for sound alerts should still come through the same, but I've been playing with that format just a little bit to kind of simplify it, so it's still in a frame that's easy to read. So, let me know, though, if you love it, you hate it, just let me know. The feedback's always welcome. It's a cool day for a birthday, right? Hey, GG's on the catch, Irem. Last minute little great ball worked out. This is always weird to me. You're like a money... There's something out here. It's a big old open area. Well, I guess there isn't. Oh, there's one. You get like $10 for those ones. Nothing else hiding in this little area. Okay. Oops, I actually hit the buttons. Iron, what are you making? Okay, so speaking of busted builds, you're